How many of you here have had the opportunity to live in a rectory, to stay in a rectory for a while? Okay, significant number. So, I'm sure you have become aware of the fact that even though you are discerning a life of celibacy, a life of not getting married, there are going to be a lot of women in your life telling you what you should do, what you should not do, and what you failed to do. I say this because every parish on the planet has a Martha. And if you find you're in a parish without a Martha, check the sign because it might not be Catholic. There's always a Martha. And this is her village where she lived with her sister Mary and her brother Lazarus. They might have also belonged to some kind of religious community. Not the Essenes, but another perhaps, because it would have been very unusual for three unmarried siblings, another unmarried rabbi, would be coming to visit them. So let's focus on Martha for just a moment. On this occasion, we find Martha coming to Jesus with her plan. Lord, tell my sister to get to work. I'm doing everything. The Lord had other plans. First of all, what he really needed was quiet. Someone to be with him. Someone to quietly listen. He was on his way to get crucified. A good dinner was probably the last thing on his mind. And he also had a plan to do something unusual. Mary was sitting at the feet of the rabbi, listening to his teachings. No longer was the rabbi's teaching to be restricted to men, but it was also to be opened up to women. So Mary or Martha went with her plans to the Lord. But the Lord had other plans. And then, on a much sadder occasion, after Lazarus had died, do you recall the words Mary said to the Lord when she met him coming into town? He was coming. It was, Lord, my brother would not have died if you had been here. Now, that's kind of off-putting. If I were Jesus standing there, I would perceive that to be, she's blaming me. If I had been here, Lazarus wouldn't have died. She knows I knew from a couple days, so it's all my fault. Again, Martha had her plan that she was sharing with the Lord. And again, the Lord had his plan. By revivifying Lazarus, by bringing him back to earthly life, he was preparing the crowds for even a greater resurrection that was going to take place in just a few days. Somebody going to the Lord with their plans when the Lord has other plans. Most of you here are discerning the Lord's plan in your life. You're discerning if the Lord is calling you to be a servant at his altar. Now, if the Lord isn't calling you, you discover that he doesn't want you to do this, that doesn't mean you're not worthy. That means he has other plans. Not less plans, but plans for you. And my brothers, if you find that the Lord is calling you, don't try to fight it. Don't try to fight it. You may feel that, okay, I could do as good of work here as there and all that, but at the end, if you don't accept the call of the Lord, you're doing the wrong job in the wrong place. But it gets even more complicated, because sometimes we feel that the Lord is calling us, but we don't feel worthy. Either we're not smart enough, we're shy, we don't want to deal with people, or we are sinful people. And we say, he can't want me. He just can't want me. My point is, the Lord is calling to service each of us, and the Lord knows who we are and what we are capable of doing. So, in our prayer, let's not take our plans to the Lord, but let's try and discern what his plans are for each of us. God bless you.